That's not me, is it?
This is your daily news at noon. Honored by the Broadcast Education Association for Best Newscast, it's Tomorrow's Journalist Today.
It's me time. Coming up next on the daily news at noon. It's just me. I don't need a co-anchor. Coming up next on the daily news at noon, I'm Jake Taylor. And things are important and are happening. I don't need a teleprompter either. Are we going to switch again? No, we're switching again to three. Yeah, you see, this is just going to be the resume reel right here. This is it. I'm going to put that pink highlighter down because that was messing up. Four! I'm on four? Wow, I didn't even see four coming. But I'm ready. I am prepared for the four. And Nikki's here. Nikki's letting me know. She's got my back.
Welcome to BYU's Daily News. I'm Katherine Hopkins.
I'm Sable Peterson.
I'm Jake Taylor.
I'm Clara Stevenson.
I'm Adam Belinsky.
And I'm Casey McRae.
And I'm Josh Guest.
And I'm Christine Pratt.
And I'm Adam Stocksdale.
And I'm John Marucci.
After 6 years in office, Republican Representative Lori Falk of Orange says she doesn't plan on running again. While in office, Falk focused on issues of transportation, economic development, and education, but now she is ready to focus her efforts elsewhere.
Still in disarray 3 days after being hit. Okay, that's fine. That's good. Lauren, what are the people saying?
John, I spent this morning on campus because my name's Lauren Christensen and I am...
People, and they're like talking, and turn!
The BYU Elementary Ed program has found another subject to be just as valuable. BYU Daily News reporter Alora Murray is here to tell us how the arts have become the top priority for BYU's future teachers.
Last Saturday, the BYU... Okay.
If you've ever been interested in what Latin American culture is all about, Rosanna Hicken has your Friday 4-on-1.
What if you haven't been interested?
I love life.
A13 is sad. That's why it gets the frowny face.
I don't like being dirty.
Thanks, Christine. New regulations mean that Utah County tanning salons are going to have to step up safety considerations. The rules the county commission passed last night require posted warnings about eye protection, also allergic reaction, and increased risk of skin cancer. Salons must provide safety equipment and goggles, lotion, and towels. One county health official says the new rules will not significantly impact the tanning business, and most patrons agree.
Keep reading.
I mean, the patron said that they know quite a few people that have skin cancer, but they don't think that it would happen to them. These regulations will go into effect after the next Board of Health meeting.
We've seen chili. Can that happen here?
Jake?
Whoa. Coming up on the daily news, shake and shimmy for... No, that is bump four. That is bump four. I will not be shaking nor shimmying. No. But still to come on the daily news at noon is something else.